Okay, let's talk about applications of integration. Before we get to specific problems, we should remind ourselves of the three questions that we have to ask about a definite integral. And really, these are the same three questions that we have to ask about any mathematical concept. The first is, what is it? And you have to remember that a definite integral is the limit of a sum. So the definition is that the integral from a to b of f of x dx is the limit, as you chop things up into more and more and more pieces, of the sum as I goes from 1 to n of f of xi star times delta x. And we've gone through the whole procedure of how you figure out what delta x is, what xi star is, and so on and so on. But it's a limit of a sum. Now, is that how you compute integrals? No way. That's hard. The way that you compute integrals is you use the fundamental theorem of calculus. You say, you find a function big F of x, whose derivative is little f, and you plug it in at the endpoints. That's a much easier way to compute things than to think of it as a limit. But it's from the limit definition that we get all of the applications. What an integral is good for is all sorts of bulk quantities. Now, what are some examples of bulk quantities? Area, volume, mass, population, probability. All of these things can be gotten by integrals. So, what's our strategy for computing any bulk quantity? If you've got a bulk quantity that you want to figure out, the idea, which I call the slice and dice principle, is the first thing is you break the bulk quantity into manageable pieces, chunks that you know, that you can understand. The big bulk quantity might be complicated, but each little piece you understand. And then you estimate the size of each piece. You say, can I find a function f of x such that the size of each piece is f of x times the width of each piece? And if I can, then I can put all the pieces together, and I get that the total is roughly the sum of the pieces. Well, roughly the sum of f of x delta x. And if that works, then I can get a better and better and better answer by chopping things into finer and finer and finer pieces, where this approximation gets better and better and better. So my exact answer is going to be a limit of sums. But hey, we know what a limit of sums is. A limit of sums is an integral. And so we have an integral, and then we evaluate the integral using the fundamental theorem of calculus. We use antiderivatives as a way to compute the integrals, but we use the definition as a limit of sums in order to figure out where the integrals actually apply. So as an example, let's look at the region between the curve, between the parabola y equals 2 plus x squared and the parabola y equals 1 minus x squared, and the line x equals minus 1, and the line x equals plus 1. This is kind of like an hourglass only turned sideways. So what's the area of this region? Well, we don't have a formula for the area of an hourglass-shaped region. We can break things up into pieces. We slice it. We break our region up into manageable slices, and then we say, what's the area of each slice? Well, the area of each slice, so the area of a slice is roughly its height times its width. And I say roughly because each of these slices is almost a rectangle, but not quite. This height is not the same as this. This height is not the same as this. It's an approximate rectangle. So to get the height, you take 2 plus x squared minus 1 minus x squared. That's the height. And the width, we'll call the width delta x. So the total area is approximately the sum of all of the n different slices of 3 minus 2, sorry, 1 minus 2x squared plus 2x squared plus x squared minus negative x squared gives you 2x squared. 1 plus 2x squared times delta x. And then in the limit, this becomes the integral from negative 1 to 1 of 1 plus 2x squared dx. Now, how do we actually evaluate that integral? Well, we use the fundamental theorem of calculus. We find a function whose derivative is 1 plus 2x squared. That's 1 plus 2 thirds x cubed. And we evaluate it at 1 and at negative 1. And that gives us 5 thirds minus negative 5 thirds. And that gives us 10 thirds, or 3 and a third. So the area of this region is 3 and a third. It's a goofy region. There's no formula for the area of this kind of region. But by chopping it up into pieces, we got a whole bunch of almost rectangles. We got the area of each almost rectangle as its height times its width. We added them together. We took the limit. We got an integral. And finally, we used the fundamental theorem of calculus to evaluate the integral.